Thanks a lot, Nancy. You know, this game between Indiana and Brooklyn, very entertaining throughout the first half. A tight contest. And then a few mistakes late in the second quarter let Indiana extend the lead, and it just felt like the Nets were never quite able to get over that hump after.
You know, Brian, you run into a problem when you have turnovers. We talked about it a little bit during the game. When you have a turnover in your front court, but it's headed towards the other basket, and there were about three of those at that point where the Pacers just took it, went down, scored easy buckets down there, and that got them rolling in terms of the momentum, and the Nets just couldn't figure out how not to turn the basketball over in key situations, led to 30 points for the Pacers off their turnovers.
Yeah, that's a big number.
Yeah, huge number.
Now, meanwhile, on the Nets side of things offensively, again, Joe Harris getting it going. We've seen how well he shoots on the road, especially from three. He ends up with 19 points, and Caris LeVert 19 points, and Jim, you made the point throughout, this guy's going so good, he needs to get more shots than he had tonight.
Yeah, I think he does. I mean, he's so good with the basketball. He's deceptive in making things happen. And you're right about Joe Harris shooting the ball very well. But when you think about it, Nets shoot 48% tonight, and they get blown out. I don't know really what that tells you other than the turnovers are mounting up against them, and they're not getting a whole lot of mileage on the turnovers on the other side. So the easier buckets start to add up. They make it easier for you to get into your offensive sets, and then the Nets trying to get some deflections just not happening defensively.
They should have Rondae Hollis-Jefferson back on Wednesday. What does getting him back do for this team?
I think just defensive activity. You know, now, once again, let's not jump to conclusions that he's going to come back after, what, a little bit more than 2 months of inactivity. Just call it approximate that, to come back and really step in and just do what he did last year for them. The one good thing about him is that he's not like a refined type of player where the only thing he does is shoot the ball and you're expecting him to shoot the ball. He comes in, he plays that all-around game, which is a little easier to find yourself, get into the flow of the game than, say, an Allen Crabbe who comes in who's a shooter and has to make sure things happen from the shooting standpoint.
One interesting thing right now schedule-wise for the Nets, and we mentioned this during the broadcast, Nets have 3 days off here, which happened just once all of last year if you don't include the All-Star break. How valuable is it to have that kind of time off at this point in the season for Kenny Atkinson and his staff?
I think it's huge from the standpoint of, you know, tomorrow they probably get a day off, but use those two couple of days for practicing, get your guys, get them healthy for the guys who are banged up, so that helps a little bit. But I think it gives Kenny Atkinson and his staff a little bit of a reason to pull things together and kind of do what we're doing. Let's step away here. Let's analyze what our team problems are. Try to get a day or two. It's not a training camp. It's no substitution for that. But get at least 2 days where you can come in there and say, hey, guys, we need to focus on A, B, and C to get better because we're doing the other things pretty well.
Well, the Nets fall tonight, Nancy, 132-112. They turn their attention to a few days off before back on the road for a couple of games as we send it back to you.